I am a landscape architect, publisher and podcaster, and I had the pleasure of designing 20 natural playgrounds in kindergartens and free school grounds.
Our gardens serve children and teachers. They allow close contact with nature. They should be an everyday landscape.
We are from the Syriza Playground. We started this organization about 1 year ago out of a love in Brussels.
Painting murals together with people, allowing them to discover the neighborhoods in creative ways. It is a community that allows us to exist, so we really take the contribution very seriously.
I work in the nature-based enterprise Cuatro Rayas, located in A Coruña, Spain. We rebuild spaces and landscapes to make them more efficient and sustainable. We work with the Cultural Association of Leira to take cultural context into account when planning organic farming projects.
Where is the School of Looking?
Our project is the Eco Showboat, a zero-carbon floating art science infrastructure.
The venue is a historic barge where we will develop art, science and educational projects about climate change and freshwater ecology.
And we'll be working with communities we meet as we travel across Ireland, navigating the inland waterways.
This is Damian, a head of development from Deepster, innovation-oriented SME from Koper, Slovenia, a country about 60% covered by forest. We develop wooden furniture without artificial materials using domestic wood species, 100% natural processing with no chemical additives, biodegradable and recyclable. Our furniture won several international design awards and have been recognized as excellent eco-product.
I am the founder of Bollenstreekhout in the Netherlands, collecting trees and upgrade them to local product. We like to put new trees for every tree we are receiving. Our main activity is become a source bank for trees.
I'm an architect and the managing director of Helix Pflanzensysteme in Convestheim, Germany. We develop vertical green systems, we build and maintain instant green noise barrier walls and manage the growth of the vegetation. We love to work with nature and have the ecosystem services of our vertical green gardens to make urban areas more livable and more resilient.
Gecko Gardens is a nature-based enterprise located in Stuttgart, Germany. We empower city people to produce organic food everywhere. We do this with our gecko garden systems, which fertilize and irrigate themselves automatically. Your kitchen waste gets recycled in our integrated vermicompost and enables you to produce fresh herbs and vegetables everywhere.
Well, the Citizen By Garden is a combination of a garden, and it also has space and storage space for bikes. There is a blackboard that is also meant for communication with neighbors. So it actually combines three things: a garden, a bike shed, and a way to communicate and cooperate with neighbors. A lot of neighbors actually wanted to contribute, and so the team actually evolved into this beautiful group of people that came and went and all put their tiny contributions to the garden.
I'm from company Naturhem Solutions in Belgium. We've been active since 2018 as a consultancy in the field of water management and treatment.
Our mission is to protect bees and to spread urban beekeeping as a virtuous practice for sustainable cities and communities. In 2019, we developed and we launched across the globe an innovative urban beehive who makes beekeeping safe, simple and interactive.
I'm an ecological engineer and entrepreneur dedicated to applying emerging technologies to improve the health of urban ecosystems for future generations. I work with a company called Soil Mania and combines decades of experience in soil biology and arboriculture to create three different state-of-the-art soil sensors. Our most popular is the soil moisture sensor, which lets people understand where soil is too dry and where it might need water. This can really revolutionize nature-based solutions and how we manage green infrastructure, mostly because we're moving from a currently very reactive sector to a proactive sector.
The most important challenge we face is education. We talk and write about nature deficit disorder and why play in the nature is so important for small children.
We are engaging the community with participatory activities and try to build bridges between the communities, between the different groups, and also strengthen their connection with the city itself.
When planning organic farming projects, considering factors such as location and levels of sunshine. And we also carry out digital surveys to propose consensual ideas like in a Coruña Hosa Park.
Main challenge is actually to get funding to pre-finance the source, because time from receiving the tree up to fabricated the product is approximately 1 to 2 years, depending on the species.
So is it perfect? No, it is not. But do we need more projects like this to learn how to cooperate, to learn how to talk to each other and to have conversations about the future of our city? Yes, absolutely. It's only by doing those projects that we learn how to work together.
The main challenge we've encountered in that field is the lack of regulatory constraints and also a lack of client awareness about nature-based solutions.
One of the main challenges we run into is helping people understand that technology is not something to be afraid of. In fact, technology can really help optimize the way that we manage nature-based solutions.
If I could give you some advice, talk with people about their fears, explain, educate, and be patient.
You are a nature-based enterprise. Does it make a difference for people and for society what you do and the services you offer? Then go ahead, stick to your goals and do one step after the other. You are going to perform a marathon. Make sure you can earn money with your doings and be aware of your resources.
Stay patient, keep going, and believe in yourself. All the good things take time.
Pilot it, test it, and keep iterating and rapid prototyping until you've found something that works. Don't forget to tell everybody about the great work you're doing. Communication is half the battle.
I like to say that it's important to know the past to build the future.
Our advice to succeed and grow is to dream big and never forget why you're doing what you're doing.